ಧರ್ಮತರೋರ್ವಿವೇಕಜಲಧೇಃ ಪೂರ್ಣೇಂದುಮಾನಂದದಂ ವೈರಾಗ್ಯಾಂಬುಜಭಾಸ್ಕರಂ ಹ್ಯಗಗನ ತ್ವಾಂತಾಪಹಂ ತಾಪಹಂ ಮೋಹಾಂಬೋಧರಪೂಗಪಾತನವಿಧೌ ಸ್ವಸಂಭವಂ ಶಂಕರಂ ವಂದೇ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಕುಲಂ ಕಲಂಕಶಮನಂ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮಭೂಪಪ್ರಿಯಂ ಸಾಂದ್ರಾನಂದಪಯೋದಸೌಭಗತನುಂ ಪೀತಾಂಬರಂ ಸುಂದರಂ ಪಾಣೋಪಾಣಶಾಸನಂ ಕತಿಲಸತ್ ತೂನೀರಭಾರಂ ವರಂ ರಾಜೀವಾಯತಲೋಚನಂ ಧೃತಜಟಾ ಜೂತೇನ ಸಂಶೋಭಿತಂ ಸೀತಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣಸಂಯುತಂ ಪಥಿಗತಂ ರಾಮಾಭಿರಾಮಂ ಭಜೆ ರಾಮಾಭಿರಾಮಂ ಭಜೆ.
Number 15 in Aranyakanda is where we stopped. Maya is an apukahu. The verse characterizes basically the ignorance of jiva and the other qualities of Ishvara, bandha mocha prada. Ishvara is he who gives bondage and moksha, or the bestower of bondage and moksha, meaning to say the manifestation of the pairs of opposite in the world, with bondage and moksha, joy and sorrow, and all this manifested universe, Ishvara is the cause for the manifestation. And Sarvapara is beyond the cause and effect. And Maya Prerak, the wielder of Maya. So, three things are given about Ishvara, and one thing is given about Jiva only. What? Ignorance. Jiva's surname is Agyan. His last name, in his passport, last name should be Agyan. First name he can put Gyan, but last name will still be Agyan. Because some people's first name is Gyan, you know. Yeah. Last name will remain Agyan. Maya isana apu kahu. Jan, na, the na goes with na jan. That is the means na janati, means he doesn't know. Maya is apu, three things. It is jagat created by Maya, and Maya itself, Ishvara, and apu is himself. Na janati kahiya so jeev, that is the one who is called as jeev. Jeeva. And then when we get to Uttarakhand, it'll come back. I told you that you can go there and see. Now we'll see that from today, we have to see that other passage now. Your question is, what is bhakti? He saved bhakti for last. Even though bhakti was asked as, kaho gyan biragaru maya kahi so bhagati karahu jehi daya. Bhakti was given at fourth place. But now it is left for last, because the best is always left for last. When we are eating, we take that mithai last only, isn't it? Everybody keep their gulab jamun, and that on those days they don't turn their head, you know, because if you turn like that, somebody will be going there. So they keep their head straight. Okay, now see that.
ಧರ್ಮತೆ ಬಿರತಿ ಜೋಗತೆ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮೋಕ್ಷ ಪ್ರದ ಭೇದ ಬಖಾನ ಜಾತೆ ಬೇಗಿ ದ್ರವವು ಮೇ ಭಾಯಿ ಸೋ ಮಮ ಭಗತಿ ಭಗತ ಸುಖದಾಯಿ सो सुतंत्र अवलंबन आना तेहि आधीन ज्ञान विज्ञाना भगति तात अनुपम सुख मूला मिलई जो संत होई अनुकूला भगति की साधन कहऊ बखान सुगम पंथ मोहि पावहि प्राणी प्रथम बे प्रचरण अति प्रीति निज निज कर्म निरत श्रुति रीति एहि कर फल पुनि विषय विराग तब मम धर्म उपज अनुराग श्रवणाधिक नव भक्ति दृढ़ाई मम लीला रति अति मन माही संत चरण पंकज अति प्रेमा मन क्रम बचन भजन दृढ़नेमा गुरु पितु मातु बंधु पति देवा सब मोहि कह जाने दृढ़ सेवा मम गुण गावत पुलक शरीरा गद गद गिरा नयन बहनीरा काम आदि मद दम्बन जाके तात निरंतर बस में ताके वचन कर्म मन मोरी गति वचन करही निकाम इनके निर्णय कमल महु करहु सदा विश्राम सियावर राम चंद्र कुमार की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई
धर्मते बिरति दिस इज अ शॉर्ट सेंटेंस दैट इज द सेंटेंस एक्चुअली धर्मते बिरति फ्रॉम धर्मा रिजल्ट्स बिरति बिरति मींस वैराग्य विराग From Dharma, now see, this Rama tells to Lakshmana this statement, right? From Dharma stems Vairagya, comes Vairagya. So now we have to figure out that, it means it's given for Vichar. So Vichar has to be done, right? How from the following of Dharma, Vairagya will result? Because in our Vedanta, what we learn, from the Viveka comes Vairagya. So that seems to be something else. So then Rama did not study Vedanta or what? You can't say. I told you, you have to develop uha poha vichakshana. Means you have to see how it is right and how it is correct. It's from Dharma. So when one adheres to one's Dharma, what is meaning of dharma here? Means one's duty. How we know? It's because dharma has many meanings, isn't it? Huh? We know because in a few lines down, I'll show you now. If you go down, प्रथम ही विप्रचरण अति प्रीति यू सीइंग अ लाइन गो डाउन अ फ्यू लाइन सी गो प्रथम ही विप्रचरण अति प्रीति देन ही सेज नेक्स्ट लाइन सेज निज निज कर्म निरत श्रुति रीति सो निज निज कर्म मीन्स वन्स ओन ड्यूटी निज निज कर्म निज मीन्स वन्स ओन कर्म मीन्स ड्यूटी राइट बट देन आफ्टर दैट सी द नेक्स्ट लाइन एहि कर फल पुनि विषय विरागा द रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट फॉलोइंग वन्स ओन डूइंग वन्स ओन कर्म दैट रिजल्ट इज विषय विरागा मीन दिस पैशन टुवर्ड्स ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड विषय विषय सो हियर निज निज कर्म leads to Vishaya Viraga. So that's the same thing is here on a Dharmate Virati. So here dharma means following one's own duty. So the first thing is we have to determine which meaning of dharma is to be taken here. So the meaning of dharma to be taken here is duty. You know, dharma means righteousness, dharma means duty, dharma means the nature of something. Dharma has many meanings. So here duty. So from following one's duty, one gains vairagya. That is the equation. Oh, so then how? So then you have to give some thought to that a little bit. See, suppose I am a blacksmith. They make horseshoes, you know. I don't know if we have blacksmiths anymore. I don't know if horses have shoes anymore. But blacksmith is to make horseshoes. Suppose that is his work, right? He's happened to be born in this house. His father was a blacksmith. He trained him to be a blacksmith and trained him to make the best horseshoes in town. So he's making horseshoes. But his eyes leaves his duty there and he starts thinking, my neighbor is a merchant, you know, and he makes a lot of money. My neighbor is a merchant, makes a lot of money, travels to this place, buys this thing at such a cheap cost and sells it 10 times the amount here. Look at money he is making. The moment he leaves his own duty and his eyes go there, see here, what are you supposed to think? I am making these horseshoes and I am serving all the horse owners in my town, in my village, who are here. And this is the little bit of duty that has been given to me by the Lord. And I am doing this duty, Ishwararpanam, Ishwararpitam, na ichchaya kritam. He's supposed to do that duty like that. And Bhagavan has blessed me with this capability of making horseshoes. But what happened? In the society in which we are born, some wild materialistic dream is pumped into our head. You have to make a $1,000,000, like that. So that dream now makes him forget his duty and look at the nervous. Well, I'm making a lot of money, man. I'm making horseshoes. I will never get rich. But he doesn't give any worth thereafter to his duty. The worth is to make $1,000,000. The thing is important is to make $1,000,000. The duty is not important. So then his eyes go there and he leaves this thing and goes into that and he goes into it. So then you think his desires will get less. Oh, no such thing as vairagya or birati will come. If one adheres to that duty, may be the most minuscule thing or it may be the most what the society considers to be unimportant. Society may consider that horseshoe making to be unimportant, but Ishvara has no such important and unimportant, because Ishvara could just blow through one nostril and blow away Houston. So Houston is also not important. You see, in Ishvara's eyes, what is important? That's why he says, Ishvara Arpitam. But that person who is doing that duty and offering it to the Lord, that thing becomes his own means of developing vairagya. So he has to stick to that duty and do it up as prescribed by the nija nija karma nirata shruti riti. Shruti riti means how the shruti has laid down. The shruti has laid down, Ishwararpitam nechaya kritam chitta shuddhakam mukti sadhakam. So it will give chitta shuddhi when we offer it to Ishwara. So the Shruti has laid down in certain ways. Gita will see also. So many verses strewn everywhere. All these ideas. So when he first of all sticks to his duty and do it according to the Shastra, certainly it will lead to Vairagya. And not just like that, do the duty, but my mind is there. I'm doing, and every day I'm complaining how Bhagavan dealt me an unfair blow. My neighbor is making so much money, and look at me. I am making peanuts with horseshoes. So every day he's only harping on one thing, tune only, one string. Bhagavan dealt me an unfair blow, unfair hand. Hand? Unfair hand, yeah. And that fellow so lucky, he have a yacht. And look me, I have a hat. Blacksmith hat. stick to the duty and do it with Ishwara Arpana. Then only it will lead to Vairagya. See, when he says Chitta Shodhakam, it will lead to purity of mind, right? Is it? In Upadesara, Chitta Shodhakam. But attachment is a great impurity in the mind. So detachment will come. That impurity in the mind there, when he says it will lead to purity of mind, what is the impurity? Attachment, raga, dvesha, ityadi, all of that will go away. So, dharmate birati means attachment will go away, detachment will come from following one's own dharma. Dharmate birati, jogate jnana. Jogate jnana means from yoga comes jnana. Yoga means all sorts of things. Yoga. Just now we saw abhyasta means practice. Yoga also means austerity. Yoga also means meditation. Yoga means so many things. So here, yoga means austerities. Austerities means to be able to deny oneself all the regular nice things which we like. We like very many nice things which we cannot do without. The mark of a spiritual person is the ability to just give up anything, just like that. Next day, if I have to give up and just go and be somewhere in that backyard there with nothing, then okay, I'm fine. If we can't, that means that there is no iota of spirituality. So, from this austerity means, from this ability to just give up things and to live with bare minimum, let the body and the mind and the senses and all go through some tapas, yeah. Let them burn a little bit. And we don't like that burning. Little burning also we don't like. So, from that austerity, jnana will come. How? It means to say that austerity, I told you about that section in Gita. Bhagavan gives amanitvam adam bhitvam ahimsa kshanti rajavam acharyo pasanam shausham, like that. He gives a long list of things, right? And in the end he calls them as gyan, but they're not gyan, these are just virtues, qualities. And Bhagavan Bhashyakar says because these virtues, qualities, when developed, they lead to jnana. So austerity lead to jnana. That is the idea. Eh? From following this austerity, it means that it makes my mind more conducive, makes my mind for jnana, makes my mind more ready, makes my mind more receptive for jnana. These austerities and all. Jogate jnana, jnana mocha prada, and jnana leads to moksha. Knowledge leads to moksha. And who says? Veda bakhana. The Vedas say. It means to say, and see, even when Bhagavan is talking in Bhagavad Gita, and here Bhagavan Sri Ram in Ram Gita, both of them are saying Vedas say. they are also quoting Vedas. How important our Vedas are. The Lord himself quotes, Yasya Nishvasitam Vedaha. The Vedas, his breath, he's talking about his own breath. So, he says the Vedas say. What the Vedas say? Jnana Moksha Prada. The Jnana brings Moksha, or Jnana gives Prada. Prada means gives. Prada Dati, it gives. But then, it sounds like Jnana is the result. Jnana is the result of something. Not like that. It means to say that the Jnana removes the Ajnana. Jnana removes Ajnana. Ajnana is what is? Bondage. So Jnana removes Ajnana. The removal of bondage is moksha. That is the idea. Removal of bondage is moksha. Veda Bakhana, all the Vedas say like that. Jate Begi. But, see now. He introduces in the first line, Dharmate Birati Jogate Jnana Jnana Moksha Prada. He introduces Jnana and the path of Jnana. But then he says, I'll tell you, Jate Begi, Begi means quickly, quick, fast. Begi means vega, swiftly, fast. Vega, vega, we have seen before. Jate Begi, Dravau, Dravau means melt. Mai bhai, that which quickly makes me melt. Is what? So mama bhagati, that is my bhakti, devotion to me. Bhagata Sukhadai and gives joy to the Bhakta. That which makes me melt very fast is Bhakti, and it give, that Bhakti gives joy to that Bhakta. So, Tulsidashi sometimes makes this type of comparison. He says, in one chapai, both things are coming. Jnana and Bhakti. And he seems to give preference for Bhakti. But just now he says, Jnana gives moksha. And why preference of Bhakti? I told you before that Bhaktas don't want moksha. They say, I don't want any moksha. Let me have Janama Jana Prati Rama Pada. Birth after birth, I'll revel in the feet of Ram. You see? But then, Tulsidasji is so complete in his presentation. For the one who wants moksha, that this is the path. See, Jnana gives moksha. But the Bhakti Marg doesn't, they don't care about moksha and all. And so, one more thing about that. You know, moksha comes for a person, Bhagavan says in Gita, Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate Vasudeva sarvamiti sarvamiti samatma sudhulva. He says that after many, many countless births, this person comes to me. So if we are going to have many countless births to get moksha, look, better we develop bhakti, because we'll suffer like anything. We'll be caught by maya all the time. And I told you last night that they say, wherever there is maya, they cannot, wherever there is bhakti, maya cannot come there. So if I'm going to take so many births to get this moksha, but in the meantime develop bhakti. That is one way to say. The other way to say, who told I am going to take many births? I am going to get moksha in this. If one has that resolve, then don't have to develop anything. Only austerities. Jogate jnana. Jate begi dravau mai bhai. To melt the heart of the Lord. To melt the heart of Ishvara, oh yeah, Ishta Devata actually. To melt the heart of, here in this case, Rama. That which melts my heart. So Mama Bhagati, Bhagavan is speaking in the first person. Jate hoi, jate begi dravau, mei dravau, which makes me mei and Mama. He's speaking about himself, you see, which makes me melt quickly. fast is devotion and that bhakti. And he glorifies that bhakti. Now see, one more thing. And no definition of bhakti is given, because always people ask, what is bhakti? So how will you define love? Define? Start. Some people say, can I make a call to find out how you'll define love? Can't define. You see? But he tells few things about that bhakti. He says, so sutantra avalambana ana. Bhakti is swatantra. Swatantra means, sutantra is given there. Yeah? Sutantra means swatantra. Swatantra means independent, free. Avalambana ana. The explanation of swatantra. It doesn't need any other adhar or support or any such thing. Well, what is the meaning of that? See, if we enter the path of jnana, right? So the tradition is what? You go into some ashrama there, then that guru will give some seva to do. And then he'll give some Gayatri mantra and he'll tell, okay, do this Sandhya Vandan. He'll give that Janeya one. And there's an initiation and all that, no? So then there's a process. And then when he sees that a student is fit at the ripe age and all that, he'll start giving knowledge. Because he goes to a Gurukul. So there's a process and he has to be initiated and all of that sort of thing, right? Saguru meva vigachet. He has to go to that Guru, Samit Pani, Shrutriyam, Brahmanishtam. With his samit in his hand. Samit means some firewood, something. Right? So some all traditions. So the path of jnana requires that initiation, proper approach of the guru, that initiation, and then seva, and so many things. Then only jnana is imparted. So jnana is dependent on many things preceding that. Jnana. Bhakti is dependent on what? Yeah, nothing. The most, rustic, neophyte, anybody, he need nothing. Everybody chanting Ram Ram, you start chanting Ram Ram. You come, what is everybody saying? They're saying Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. What is that? Never mind, just say. You don't need any initiation, any formal things, no, nothing. Janeyu. First we give you Janeyu, then we'll tell you what is Ram. Nothing. So sutantra, swatantra it is, independent of bhakti is like that. Where anybody, anytime, any place. Nothing. One fellow was saying Ram, Ram, Ram inside the toilet. So Hanumanji was passing. So Hanumanji said, what? He's defiling my Rama's name inside the toilet, he's chanting Ram. But chanting the name of Ram has no rules. But Hanumanji felt offended. So when that, he waited outside that toilet. When that man came out, he gave him one. And that fellow just turned on. And looked at him and walked away. A blow from Hanumanji and nothing happened. And he walked away. Then Hanumanji was also surprised. He went to Rama to complain. When he went there, he saw a bump on Rama's head. Prabhu, what happened? He said, you hit me and you're asking me what happened? Said, devotee was saved only by Bhagavan's grace, or the blow came to Rama himself. So the name, taking the name of Lord has no rules also. And Nama Smaran is part of bhakti. So like that, there are no rules, no requirements, no pre-requirements, qualifications, no time, no place, no. Avalamba na ana, he doesn't need it. This time, his Sandhya Vandan. Brahma Muhurt only you chant. No time, no place, no nothing, none of these rules. So he's glorifying bhakti here before telling the practice of bhakti. Jate begi dravau me bhai so mama bhagati bhagat sukhadai. That which makes my heart melt is devotion, and that devotion brings joy to a devotee. Really speaking, the only joy, real joy in this, see, there's joy from eating laddu. There's joy from going to that roller coaster. Oh, I know, nowadays bungee jumping. And most people, when they go there, then they change their mind. And some people go skydiving. And our Swamini who came, she's coming next month. Swamini from Toronto, she went skydiving. And then when she came down on the ground, she got... It's nothing. People get joy from skydiving, bungee jumping, this, that, all sorts of people get what type of joy? Adrenaline rush. Bhakti is the only joy that doesn't have a cost. Every joy of this world has a cost. Yes, you get the adrenaline rush, but the adrenaline rush also brings many other unwanted physiological effects on the undesirable physiological effects on the body. Adrenaline rush is there in nature for emergency purposes. This fellow uses it to get joy. Something is wrong. Survival instinct. But here he uses it. Ah! And he jumps there like a... So, bhagate sukhadai, it gives joy to the bhakta. Even the cost, why you say this has no cost? If you say that there's a cost, yes. He has to practice bhakti and then he'll get joy. The cost also is joy. The practice of bhakti also is joy. So then there's no cost, because there's joy in the practice and joy in the result. There's joy both times. Otherwise, every worldly joy has a cost. All right, we shall see now. I want to stop because Swamiji is leaving in 15 minutes. Now everybody will gather to see Swamiji off. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.